Today, the nation's first law officer, Christian Porter, fronting up, confirming he's the cabinet minister at the centre of a historical rape allegation and strongly protesting his innocence.
And it's the truth, and that is that nothing in the allegations that have been printed ever happened.
Mr. Porter is alleged to have raped a teenager in 1988 while at a student debating competition in Sydney. He says he knew the young woman.
I was 17 years old and the other person was 16. It was a long time ago. I'd always remembered it. It was a happy time. But I can say categorically that what has been put in various forms, in allegations, simply did not happen.
The allegations came to light last week after politicians were sent an anonymous letter outlining the claims. It was referred to authorities, though New South Wales police found insufficient admissible evidence to proceed. That's because the woman who made the allegation took her own life last year and never made a formal complaint. Mr. Porter addressing her family.
That I do not mean to impose anything more upon your grief, but I hope that you will also understand that because what is being alleged did not happen, I must say so publicly.
The Attorney General outright denying he ever had any sexual contact with the woman.
I did not sleep with the victim. We didn't have anything of that nature happen between us.
Mr. Porter saying he's become the victim of a trial by media and was never given the opportunity to defend himself.
While I have followed the rules and stayed silent, I have been subject to the most wild, intense, unrestrained series of accusations that I can remember.
He's now considering legal action.
And some of the stuff online is just, I mean, it's just incredible. I will look at it all.
With a police investigation now over, the lawyer who represented the woman says a denial is not enough.
Given his position and given the gravity of the allegation, it needs to be a formal, properly constituted inquiry led by someone appropriately eminent.
What would I say in front of that inquiry? What would that inquiry ask me to do? To disprove something that didn't happen 33 years ago.
Labor says the Prime Minister needs to step in.
It's very clear that in my mind that this will require further leadership and action from the Prime Minister.
Mr. Porter adamant he's done nothing wrong and won't step aside.
My guess is that if I were to resign and that set a new standard, well, there wouldn't be much need for an Attorney General anyway, because there would be no rule of law left to protect in this country.
But he will take a period of medical leave.
All of my life, I've just pushed through. But for the many caring family and friends who've asked me that question over the course of the last week, are you okay? I've got to say, my honest answer is I really don't know.
Uncertain of his future, but certain of one thing.
I will finish by saying the things that I have read did not happen. They just never happened.